Canadians, by and large, are healthy. Life expectancy in Canada is one of the highest in the world. Today, on average, a Canadian woman can expect to live to 84 years and a man to 80. We are more educated than ever, and fewer of us are living below the poverty line. But that is not the whole picture. My name is Theresa Tam, and I am Canada's Chief Public Health Officer. Every year, I publish a national snapshot of the health of Canadians. It describes our country's promising health trends and pressing health priorities. Nearly half of all Canadian adults live with at least one chronic health condition. Chronic diseases are the single greatest burden on Canada's population. But there is some good news. According to recent data, Canadians are developing some of the most common chronic diseases less often. I think this is promising because a small decrease in chronic disease rates can make a big impact over time. On the other hand, I have some concerns. Our national childhood vaccination rates have been stalled for almost a decade. If we continue to fall short on vaccination targets like this one, preventable diseases like measles could resurge. This would put our most vulnerable at risk. Antibiotics are medicines that we rely on to save lives, but drug-resistant bacteria are already changing our health. If we do not rapidly change the way we use antibiotics, we risk losing our ability to treat everyday infections or deliver essential and life-saving treatments like surgeries and chemotherapy. At the same time, the rates of sexually transmitted infections are surging. Syphilis cases have almost tripled. Substance use can be harmful. I'm concerned that many Canadians are at risk, especially young people. 4 out of 5 Canadian adults drink alcohol, and 1 of those 5 is a heavy drinker. More than half of Canadian teens say they drink, and more teens are vaping, just as we're learning of its serious and avoidable health effects. Opioid-related deaths continue to be a particularly pressing concern. Last year, 12 people in Canada died every single day. Street drugs are largely to blame. And for the first time in 4 decades, Canada's life expectancy has plateaued for men and women. This is largely due to the sheer number and young age of opioid-related lives lost. This number could have been higher if not for the public health measures already put in place. While Canadians, by and large, are healthy, certain groups experience poorer health than others, often due to factors beyond their control. These differences are driven by unfair treatment in society, the economy, and through history. So to change numbers like these, we must look beyond simply changing people's behaviors and change our institutions, our neighborhoods, and our society at large. We must also pay increasing attention to the health threats of climate change. A changing climate may reveal new risks or magnify health challenges we already face. And while different regions will face different challenges, we must work together to adapt. We all have a role in improving the health of Canadians. By taking action on these priorities and others in my annual report, we can help all Canadians achieve the best health possible, now and in the future.